before you took on this job, were you aware of these novels or of Rizal in any way?
I have to say, hand on heart, to my shame, I didn't know them. And I've never been to the Philippines either. So it's been a sort of great, you know, deep sea plunge into, you know, these two masterworks. I think the overwhelming struggle of human beings to overcome colonialism, find your own independent voice, is what drives all the way through. It has a great narrative. To read it was a real pleasure.
I mean, having, you know, brought them to life in this production, do you think they could gain a wider audience in outside the Philippines or in the UK, for example?
I hope so. I think that the appetite for audiobooks, especially podcasts now, where previously, I can remember when I first started doing audiobooks, they always had to be abridged. Whereas now you can have everything, you know, so miniaturized. And I think that that's revolutionary for really hearing the book unabridged by anybody. People really get into it when they can hear the thing in its completed version.
And one of the challenges of audiobooks, of course, is that you have to bring to life all these different characters.
Yeah.
And Noli has a huge range of characters. And was that a particular challenge in this case?
It was, because, you know, you have to make the choice. You've chosen me as somebody who's British, who lives here, to do a book that is a national classic in the Philippines. So there is a risk that you have taken by having somebody who's non-Filipino reading these voices and accents that are from this island rather than your islands. As a reader, you imagine what the people are going to sound like and what they look like.
There will undoubtedly be
critics
and people who say, you know, that we need to do them in Filipino as well. But my intention was always to make Rizal better known outside, make them accessible to the context of these two books, and that they sparked off the revolution against the Spanish, and they loom very large in the national culture.
You can go into something thinking, yeah, it's like if you play a classical role where, right, you know, there's umpteen people famous before you have played those parts.
Right.
Once you start doing it, you have to invest your own interpretation and your own, bring whatever talent you have. You live or die by that. You can't really go in, otherwise the weight of reputation would flatten you out.
Richard, thank you so much for
your
help.
Thank you.
And,
I hope it's a great success.
Yes, we'll do everything we can to make it so. And
all
certainly,
right,
you've certainly done your part.
Well, I've loved doing it. So
thank
it's
you.
Been a joy to do it. Thank you.